2, Chapter 14 of A Tale of Two Cities is called The Honest Tradesman. It opens with Jerry Cruncher and his lousy son sitting outside Telson's bank when they notice a funeral procession approaching. Jerry is alarmed at his son's excitement. As the procession nears, they see there's only one mourner and a crowd of spectators is bawling and hissing and cursing out spies. Jerry asks another spectator who the dead man is, and they're told it's the Old Bailey spy, Roger Cly. The mourner flees the crowd, who overtake the procession, filling the carriage and clinging to its roof. After burying the spy, the crowd becomes a mob, hassling passersby, breaking windows, plundering pubs, and causing general mayhem and destruction. The crowd breaks up when they hear the guards are on their way. Jerry, who has stayed in the graveyard, discusses the dead man with the undertakers and makes a note of the location of the freshly dug grave. He stops in to see a surgeon before making his way back to Telson's, where young Jerry tells him no jobs came up while he was gone. After berating his wife verbally yet again at the table, Jerry goes out to do his nighttime job, which is illegal, but helps him make ends meet. Young Jerry sneaks out to follow him because his father claims he's going fishing, but he doesn't bring a pole. Jerry is joined by two other fishermen. Young Jerry follows and watches them go fishing with a shovel, eventually pulling out a casket. When he sees his father about to open the casket, he's so terrified, he runs all the way home and hides in the closet, falling asleep. He wakes to the sound of his dad beating Mrs. Cruncher while blaming her for opposing his business. The next morning, young Jerry asks his father what a resurrection man is. Jerry pretends he doesn't know. The boy asks if it has to do with dead bodies, and Jerry says it does, for scientific purposes. Young Jerry announces he wants to be a resurrection man when he grows up, which pleases his father. It's the family business. Jerry is definitely not a fisherman, but a body snatcher who digs up bodies and sells them to surgeons and their students to dissect for research or teaching purposes. It's interesting that young Jerry, who was so scared of what he'd see in the casket the night before, decides the next day that he wants to dig up bodies for science. Perhaps the violence inflicted in his home may be mitigated a little if he does something that pleases his father. After spending the night in the closet, listening to his mother being beaten, young Jerry is likely willing to do anything to soothe his father's anger. This rapid acceptance of a rather grotesque profession may also be due to the popularity of public executions at the time, a testament to the difficult cultural and social conditions of the day that young Jerry not only accepts the idea of digging up freshly dead bodies, but also of doing something illegal in order to make enough money to live on.